Bojo, I'll start by asking you right away. You would have seen Kangana Ranaut's description of you as a soft porn star. Now, I want to clarify that I do not think that porn stars should not be treated off with dignity, that they as women too don't have their own issues. But obviously, Kangana meant it as an insult. How do you take those comments?
To be honest, Barkha, I would like to begin with no comments, really. I would like to say that I rest my case, because I don't think anything is left to be said by me. Because the beauty of this whole situation is, while she was talking all this on a TV channel at a prime time, in a manner well known and seen by most people, and unfortunately, another person sitting in that conversation, an anchor who also happens to be a woman, with a complete mad glee in the eyes and a crazy smile on the face, almost relishing the comments that Kangana was making. I think you and I should bow out and give way to the new feminism that has come up in the country. Because I just feel that also I would like to remind people that as she was saying all of this, in another half an hour, I was with Rajdeep Sardesai on his interview. Half an hour prior to that, I was on NDTV on another interview. In all of them, I have specifically complimented her as an actor that she has been, a wonderful actor, a woman who has come from a small town, made great name for herself. And I have only complimented her, and I have actually acknowledged all of those achievements that she has made so far. So I just think that it just goes to show, where we stand with whatever it is that we are trying to say. And that is precisely what I've been trying to say, that if you have a viewpoint, by all means, you have a right to express it. You have a, but it is just that the way you express it and how you express it does matter. Also, I would like to say that at one point, because a certain word was called out to her, and that happened to be called out by a man, there was a lot of uproar, and I was very happy as a normal Indian citizen to see so many men and women taking up for that. Today, as I am spoken about like this by another woman, which level should that be going to? It really all fails me, So if anybody else can put in some light.
Can I ask you, you're obviously talking, Urmila, about the Shiv Sena Sanjay Raut slur that he used for Kangana Ranaut, and all of us condemned it. And I think what you're saying is that when Kangana called you a soft porn star, you expect the same level of outrage. Can you hear me?
Absolutely.
Okay. So I will start and resume this conversation. So Urmila, where we were talking about how you said that when Sanjay Raut of the Shiv Sena attacked Kangana, everyone condemned it. And you are saying that you have not seen the same kind of condemnation when you were attacked. And you also saw that there was what you call a gleeful look in the eyes of the television anchor. So can you elaborate on that?
First of all, I'd like to say that I'm extremely and deeply touched with the kind of tremendous response that people of this country are giving. Even though I expected it essentially to be from Maharashtra, but it is all over the country, that people who are just normal, regular people, because as I speak here, I don't have any political party, person, leader, anybody or association, backing me. So there is only going to be the people, apart from my family, all kinds of people, all age groups, they have come out and put it on, whether it's Twitter, reached out to me through my family, and they have they are aghast and they are completely in shock as to what just happened. So that, having said that, I think what I was trying to say earlier was that there were a lot of other people who spoke out about one particular word being used. And I think in the context, in that sense, what word has been used to me is, I think, goes way above all the words and etc. And so therefore, I was just wondering, the Women's Commission spoke about it. So I'm just waiting for the Women's Commission, madam, and other people who spoke out at that time extremely fiercely to speak about this. Because the selective reactions, I'm not able to kind of understand, whether it is on me or on most of the women. I think I have been in Panchgani for the last 6 months due to the lockdown. in beautiful hills with my dogs and nature and cooking and reading a lot and writing a bit. My first thing that I've written has been about women empowerment. And no matter where I've gone all these years, the first and only thing I speak about is woman giving woman power, woman standing up for a woman. And therefore, I just feel it is very, very disheartening and sad to see that not only somebody is going on talking about, let alone me, whether it is a Jaya Bachchanji, who has been such a senior colleague of all of us. She has been a torchbearer of this kind, you know, the feminist, not feminist, but woman-oriented cinema, has been a member of parliament for so many years and raised voices on different other issues as well. Somebody like that to be spoken about her children, about herself, her career, her entire standing in the film industry and in the society.
You were saying that, you know,
so I was just saying that, I just feel that this ongoing thing, I really, this is the reason I spoke about this particular thing, is was not for any other reason except I wanted to bring the attention of people of India, and to begin with Maharashtra, because that's where it all started, you know, to this point, that why are we discussing all these things when at the time like this Maharashtra and the entire country should be you know, standing up together. There should be an all-inclusive kind of a stand in the entire nation, because we are dealing with such a tremendous thing called COVID-19. And, you know, I would like to bring people's attention to the fact that India has crossed the mark of 5 million COVID cases. And the last million have been just in the last 11 days. I think it's alarming and it's scary. So as people of India, we need to put all these things aside and first concentrate on the things which are really looking at us in the face. So that's what I was essentially trying to talk about. I had no interest in making any comment on Kangana personally. As you can see in all my interviews, there is nothing personal I have said about her now or prior to this. I've always been extremely, giving her compliment and extremely appreciative of her work. And also, so that is another thing. So I just only feel that this whole thing, and also she has claimed apparently that I said that she's doing all of this for BJP ticket. If anybody tells me where and which interview, in what language I have said this on, off, anywhere camera, I would just change my name. I would do anything that I'm asked for, because I never, this interview was not about BJP. This, trust me, if I want to talk about BJP, I will, and I'll make a separate whatever of it. I never spoke the two of them together. I'm just trying to bring people's attention to all the more important points.